it's time. I figured it out, of course, automatically, obviously. So, I'm going to show you how to crochet. Virka in Swedish. I have figured out how to make super tight shit. Like, really awesomely super tight. Impossible to destroy. No matter how hard you try. And I have figured out how to do it effortlessly. Because that is the trick. When you are doing this kind of business, crocheting. I don't even know if it's called crochet, but I'm going to go with crochet. Or maybe crochet. It's super simple to do. It's so easy and simple that you won't even believe it when you see it. However, the trick is to do it effortlessly without straining yourself too much. So, for starters here, you want some kind of slip knot. And yeah, I suppose that most people can do some kind of slip knot. Check it out. You want an adjustable little scenario here. En ögla. Justerbar ögla in Swedish. And yeah. It's very simple to do. You simply just... I'm going to show you again. Maybe it was hard to see. So. You put it around your fingers like so. And then you just bring it in from behind. It's a little hard to show. And then you just pull it in between like this. And the thing is that when you pull this little thread, this hole should be smaller. Nice. Yeah, it's called slip knot. If you didn't get it, watch another tutorial or whatever. It's super simple to do. So you put it on your little hook here and tighten it. And yeah. Then, it's hard to show this from the other side, but I'm going to try here. You put it like two times around your finger, and then you hold it down here as well, because you want this part to be strained. Boom, 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 boom. And then with your fingers here, you hold that part that is below, and then you simply... It's very hard to show. Yeah, you pull in the rope in between your slip knot. Like so. And yeah, that is the foundation. And this decides the length of your workpiece. I'm going to do like maybe 10 or so here. And... you might want to make them quite tight, actually. Yeah, you just take it under, bring it in. Like so. You can make this looser, of course, if you want to as well, but I'm going to show you how to make it tight in an effortless manner. And of course, you can just pull this bit up here to really simply get it through. And then you can just pull it with this finger to tighten it. And then do the same thing again. Like so. Yeah, and... this part adjusts so that the bottom part follows. Are you getting it? I think so. This is obviously not homemade nettle yarn. This is professionally made yarn that is bought. But if you are serious enough and have patience enough, of course you can make a super nice yarn with stinging nettles, for instance. Of course you can make yarn with other nature materials as well, and wool and so on. Anyway, you see that it's starting to get some length. And yeah, if you are doing a scarf or whatever, maybe you want to have it like, yeah, how long you want the scarf to be. I'm just going to show you the basics here and show you how simple it really is, because it really is. Just pull it out, drag it through, tighten it, pull it out, drag it through, tighten it, and so on. Very repetitive. Of course, there is definitely some kind of meditative aspect to this. Yes, that is going to have to be enough for this little tutorial's sake. Then, as can be seen here, or maybe not, it's black yarn, so it's a little hard. But there are small holes here that you are going to return to again. And here comes the trick. Same as before. String around here, hold it here. Then you pull this one out a bit. And you find the first hole here to enter. It's there, and then you put it through once. Now you got two little scenarios here going over, as can be seen, and then you put it through once more from up here. You go under the yarn and pull it back, and then through both of the holes, and then tighten it like so. And loosen it, and then you head for the next one. Make sure that you follow up all the way through when you are doing the little turns, because otherwise you will have like a pyramid shaped little work, and yeah, you're not aiming for that, I suppose. Yeah. Basically, pull it up again through the next hole, bring in the yarn. Ah, this was very tight here. Ah, so. And then bring in the yarn through both holes again, like so, and tighten it. And then loosen it a little, head for the next one. Bring it in, two holes, bring it in again, tighten it. Yeah, and this is basically it. This is basically what you do. Try to do it as stress-free and strain-free as possible. Just bring it in, bring it through both of them. Ah, this one I didn't unlock before I did it. I can feel. You can always pull it a little like this as well to loosen it up, but that is not necessary if you really put it hard against here and draw and then loosen up again, because then you will have something to work with. Bring it in. Bring it down and tighten it. It fucked up a little here for whatever reason. And that's a good thing, because if it fucks up, you can take this one out and then you can just pull in the string here until you are back to where it's not fucked up. And then you just bring it in again. Loosen it. Head for the next hole. Bring through once. Bring through twice. And pull. Loosen it. Next hole. Bring through once. Bring through both. And tighten it. Loosen it. Some people would call this boring, of course. However, if you make it into a really strain-free or stress-free activity, I think it can be quite nice, actually. There is something with the yarn here, but it doesn't matter if it looks kind of so-and-so at certain spots, because it will look great as a whole if you just continue doing it. The circumstances will turn out something like this after a while. Here I fucked it up in the beginning because I didn't go all the way out, but it's very important that you go all the way out when you are turning. I'm just going to go through the hole and then turn once so that you will see how to do it. And then this will be it. Through. Tighten it. Release. And it's a little bit hard to see if you are having a black yarn, as is the case here. But you can have a brighter background and then you will see the little holes that you are going through. Loosen it. Through the next one. Bring it in. Bring it in again through both. And tighten it. And loosen it. That can happen as well. That something goes wrong, and then as I was saying, you just pull the yarn until it's back to where you want to be. And then you just continue again. Be as relaxed as possible, obviously. Of course, it's quicker to do this if you do it loosely, but I don't want it to be loose. That's why I'm pulling here and then releasing a little bit here. To make it both tight and effortless. And yeah, you can do this hole quite large if you want to. Then it will be even easier to pull through both of the threads. in theory. Yeah, and in practice. Yeah. It's a little tricky until you get the hang of it, but this is most definitely a technique that I would recommend when it comes to these things. Getting close to the turning point. It's very important that you go all the way through when you are at the end here. It's hard to see. There it is. Come in! Oh, it worked. It's a little tricky in the turning points. Patience. Or the edges, or whatever you want to call it. Yeah, I think I got it. Yes, and then you simply start over again. And you can stretch it a little if you want to. Then the holes will be more obvious. And then you start at the nearest hole here again on the top row, obviously, the one that you just did. Pull through so that you will get two little ropes or holes, and then pull through again and tighten and loosen, and the next one. All right, and so on. And yeah, it goes without saying. This can be done outside. It can be done with friends or whatever, family. Sometimes family are friends. And yeah, you will get a very tight and serious result, as can be seen here. And quite effortlessly, I would say as well, if you use the whole push-pull technique that I just showed you. There are lots of ways to do it, of course. This is just an example, but I can really recommend this technique since it's so effortless and gives a very tight result nonetheless. Try it out, you will get the hang of it. It took me a number of hours before I got the hang of it. I'm very tired, so wired. Bye. Try it out. Come on, try it out.